Okay, shalom, friends, shalom, shalom. You know what Rosh Chodesh is, I'm sure you do, but the whole idea of Rosh Chodesh is that you start all over again. Really start all over again, like you were never here before. You know what the sad thing about us is? That we don't really believe we can start. We don't really believe it. We don't really believe it. We always think, you know, how can I start all over again? I'm so old. I did this. How can I start all over again? But we really can. And you know what's the beautiful thing about Rosh Chodesh is? You see, when we all start, then we love each other, because the people who start always love each other. It's only the old people, because I think I did more than you, I know more than you, and you are a greater sinner than I, but we all start all over again. We're all like one. So Rosh Chodesh is the great day, the real great day. So, friends, let's start all over again. I wish we could. Maybe it'll help each other starting. Okay, anyway, this is my song. Some of you maybe heard me already sing it. Kashenu Mitzvotef. Have you heard it already? Melody. Okay. Can you hear me, friends? Or I'm sorry if you... What do you say? What? I'm sorry, I can't hear you. What? I'm yelling already, you know, that's the best. I wish someone could make the microphone louder. Is this better? Now it's good? You gotta direct me. When it's right now, it's better, or before? Before was better. You can't open it. Okay, what can you do? Yeah? Okay, good. Okay. But friends, really join me. Make sure. The best thing you can do maybe is hate me, which is okay with me, because I love you. I don't care if you love me back, but you know, Yeshiva University is already like, you know, this is the place today, right? If someone wants to study a little bit Torah, wants to know a little bit about Yiddishkeit, this is the best he can hope for, right? But if I'm thinking to myself, judging by the spirit in this room, if this is the most we are capable of, then I hate to disappoint you, you know. I hate to tell you what I really think, you know. You know what the thing is? Everybody here in this room knows that something has to happen, right? Something has to happen to us, something has to happen to Yiddishkeit before it's too late, right? We lost 6 million Jews, this is one thing, right? We are losing millions of young Jewish people right now under our own nose. You know why? Because we lost our spirit. We lost the real spirit of holiness, of silence, of softness. Today you go somewhere, it's supposed to be religious or Orthodox. The first thing is you can, if you want to know if it's real chum, if there's noise, right? If it's a lot of noise, it's real chum. If it's obnoxious, then it's mamash the promised, right? You walk into a synagogue, gewalt, if by kriyas ha-Torah anybody is in there, it can't be too religious. If all the people are outside, talking Lashon Hara, this is the place. You know, you and I know we got to do something, right? You know, don't be angry with me. You know, if I walk in plain in ashram, they know the secret of silence. And, you know, all our Jewish kids are not the Yeshiva University. They're all Hare Krishna kids or sitting somewhere in ashrams or on the way to India. And you know why we lost them? You know why we lost them? Because we are obnoxious. Because we are, I include myself, I'm just as bad as you. Listen to me, I was sitting in yeshiva all my life like you. But you know what we have to do? We have to come more serious. Mama, serious. Well, what good is the whole thing? I don't think you have to be serious 24 hours a day. But for a few minutes when we get together, why can't we be really serious? Or why can't we, Mama, kindle a great fire? This room should be like really vibrating with fire. Really fire. Why can't we daven like mentioned? We have forgotten how to daven. And I tell you the truth there, you know. Besides my little house in San Francisco where we really daven, I have a straight shul, right? Or what is in Sovereign, in a real Orthodox shul? Kosher Pesach. But what is the greatest thing my president can tell me before Kabbalah Shabbos? What do you think? The real Shabbosic message coming of the president of an Orthodox synagogue. He says, can you please daven fast? I want to go home to eat. And he's a good man. Or what should I do is I should wring his neck and say, can you please go home and eat first and then come back and daven? I can't. But you and I know we got to daven, we got to, really, it has to be soul, it has to be with it. Kids, can we possibly be with it, really? La 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 la. La 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 You know, friends, in former good days, if the Almighty had, if someone had the privilege to study Torah, although I'm sure it was very hard, but they were not subjected to so many nisyonos, to so many trials and tests as we are today. Since Mount Sinai, since Har Sinai, it never happened. That there's a yeshiva, and 2 blocks later you have 15,000 movies, you have 10,000 discotheques. It never happened, right? It's the first time in history that God trusts us so much. God trusts us. He puts right all the evil in front of our eyes, and He still trusts us that we will sit by the Gemara, right? That means God trusts more you and me than Rashi, than the Rambam, because they didn't have this kind of test. They didn't. And even the holy Baal Shem Tov lived in a klein shtetl. What kind of test did he have? And I'm not saying this on my own. When the Bava Rebbe, who's from Amish, very holy, one of the holy masters today, one of the holiest rebbes, when he came to America, the next day he says, Gewalt, I see that B'nai Torah have the Zionists here, like the Holy Baal Shem didn't have those Zionists. So God trusts us in the most unbelievable way. So if He trusts us so much, so why didn't we do it? Can we turn on to this song? Like, man, I can't even, how can you sit there? We sing in Kachena Mitzvah Secho, please don't let me feel what the mitzvah is. You know, we are dead. We don't feel it. V'sein Chalkena B'sechol Secho, please let me feel at home. A lot of people feel at home when they read, like, let's say, they see a stupid cartoon, they feel at home. You tell them a dirty joke, they feel at home. You tell them a Shvera Rambam, not so much, right? The same Chalkeinu B'Sechol Secho, please Almighty, let it be my turn. It should be my turn, my portion. Let's go. Hey, Ivan, do we let me get something? But boys and girls don't have to dance together here. Can we maybe get a little bit order here in the yeshiva? Let's get the boys on this side and the girls on the other side. Okay, let's do it. Ta benomi, bechom esam anashenu, bishu asetam, ta benomi, bechom esam anashenu, bishu asetam,